The directive was issued by the committee vice chairperson Robert Migade Ndugwa while the Committee of National Economy was meeting officials of the Ministry of Agriculture over the performance of the $150 million agriculture cluster development project benefiting farmers in 57 districts. Migade told the committee that Parliament has received petitions of suppliers demanding payment for arrears worth 42 billion shillings, which government owes them for supplies they extended to the project.
42 billions, and this is a lot of money in supplies, 42 billions. Because there are many issues that in this country there are people who know that you can actually petition and you find the money where you never supplied.
However, the Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Agriculture, Major General David Kasura Chomkama, contested the alleged claims, saying they have not been verified.
They are not supposed to be there. Because of that, it is therefore very difficult, without delving into other things which involve investigations and fraud and the prosecutions, to come and tell you, sir, that this is an official list.
Members of the Committee of National Economy have also expressed disappointment at the poor performance of this loan, saying no tangible impact has been felt in the 57 districts where the project is being implemented.
The projects that can be appreciated by the community and that can be seen. So it is not about papers. When the impact is there, you really see it.
They're asking for extension. They have used over 70% of the resources, but the work, the physical performance of the project remains a challenge. And that's why we are saying we are not going to sit back. We are going to evaluate performance of these loans, and we want to get down to the grassroots and appreciate all this.
Okay. MPs also found out that agriculture roads which are being constructed by the Ministry of Agriculture in areas where this project is being implemented are in a poor state due to lack of funds to maintain them. They recommended to withdraw this funding and allocating it to the districts or UNRA which have road maintenance capacity.
There are schools which are not reachable. Do you want Ministry of Education to solve road chocks to their schools? Will you want Minister of Health to solve the issue of road chocks to their health centers? Minister of Agriculture, the same.
That money should be picked and given to road fund so that they can use the district to open those feeder roads. Now recruiting engineers in a project, then they do.
If you are a farmer and you are producing your banana, your maize, whatever crop it is, but you are not able to connect to the main road so that you can connect to the market, it becomes a challenge.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.